What is up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Retro Hoop Collectibles. We got mail day today. So, I know I said I haven't been doing a whole lot of buying, and that's true. I hadn't been buying a whole lot of stuff, but as I've been pulling data on population and eBay, not eBay, sorry, PSA, PSA 8s, PSA 9s, PSA 10s, things like that, I'm starting to notice a bit of a pattern, and I decided to start to test a few theories of my own by doing some experimenting. So that being said, I went ahead and did some buying in an effort to have some things to do the experiment with, and a lot of what I picked up here is just for that. But then I've also been picking up some rookies, some Allen Iverson rookies, and some, a bunch of other stuff. So we'll get into all of that. So this is a little John Morant I picked up here. Let me see if we can get this light turned on. Yeah, there we go. John Morant, PSA 7. So you're probably wondering, why the hell did you buy a PSA 7? And I'll explain that in another video. I mean, this is just... not exactly sure why this one... anyway, great looking card. And a PSA 7. Not sure why that got a PSA 7, but part of what I'm experimenting on here. Anyway. Moving on. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe. Hit the subscribe button. I got a lot of stuff coming up pretty soon. Breaks, more analytical stuff. Follow me on Instagram at RetroHoopBreaks. Check out collect3dprints.com. Okay, here is another PSA 7 that I bought. Okay, this one I can see why it got a 7 that I didn't see in the eBay listing. It's got a nasty little divot that you can see right there. See right by his hand right there. So this one's probably warranted, but so I guess I'll kind of let you guys in on what I'm... well, I'd rather not. I think you guys are smart enough. You guys kind of know, probably based on my videos and based on, what I've been doing lately. Kind of what probably... I've had actually a few of you reach out to me and kind of give me your guesses. I hate... oh, this dude didn't even put it in a... oh my God, look at that. That is just terrible. Yeah, this one's getting returned for sure. That's getting returned for sure. That is a terrible... I mean, just terrible, terrible way to ship a card. I mean, first of all, this is a Fleer metal. And it is all, I mean, just look at that. Look at that corner. Look at that corner. Nowhere in the description was any of this crap. Then the guy sticks it in a freaking top loader with no sleeve. Nope. Unacceptable. That is going back. That is going back ASAP. All right. Well, that was terrible. Please do not ship your cards like that. right, so here is PSA 8. Allen Iverson, bit of whiting on the corners. Maybe a little off center is probably why. But pretty dope card there. A little Allen Iverson action. Da, 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 da. Let's see what else we got here. Man, am I glad I picked up some Clint Capella stuff when I did. Oh, look, speaking of that, I think I said that because I kind of had a feeling that this was what that was. Very, very, very excited about Clint Capella being in the Eastern Conference Finals. Y'all know, those of you who've been watching this channel for a while, two things. Number one, you guys know I've been a big fan of Clint Capella, but number two, you guys know how much I absolutely... Oh, okay. Well, look, that's kind of cool. If you are going to put scotch tape on there, he at least doubled it back so I can take it off, which is kind of, it's kind of nice, I guess. Man, I'm so happy. Pick up this bad boy. Look at that. Very nice. Even though it says Atlanta Hawks still in his Rockets uniform. Very dope. Look at that shimmer, man. That shimmer is just nice. Very, very excited to have that in the old collection. That's PC. That's a PC item right there. Without a doubt. Da, 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 da. All right. Okay, here's another PSA slab. Here's Michael Jordan. Now, I've been picking up these slabs, these PSA 7s, PSA 8s for like dirt cheap. I think my target price was like $10 to $15 a card. And I've been picking these up really cheap. This is a perfect example of a great looking card that is just off-centered. And I don't think it deserves a 7. This is not a 7. I'm sorry. It's just... Let me go. It just does not deserve to be a 7. The surface on this card is immaculate. The corners are as sharp as can be. And the only issue with this card is that it's off-centered. For some reason... For some reason, it got a 7. I don't think that's right. So we're going to see. We're going to see what's what. All right. Order number. Oh, so shout out to my man, Pete. I'll link his channel in the description. He hit me up about this card. This is a Hakeem Olajuwon, the 94 Classics on card auto. My man Pete, he's always hit me up about this kind of stuff. We'll take it out of this dingy top loader. On card auto, I think I paid $30 for it, if that, something like that. I can't remember exactly what the price was. But again, shout out to my man Pete for hooking me up with... He already had... I mean, if you haven't watched his channel, I'll link it in the description. He's got probably one of the best Hakeem Olajuwon collections I've seen. of early 90s, Hakeem Olajuwon cards. He's got a channel where he's showing them off. But he put me up on this one. Center of Attention, Hakeem Olajuwon. Just an awesome card. On card auto from the early 90s. Very rare that they were doing that as part of the product. So very excited to have that. I guess we'll get into this one because you guys have seen my video before about how to ship cards, and I mean that is just not. I mean, I got lucky with this one, but that is not the ideal way to ship cards. Let me tell you, because that is super sketch. I mean, 99 cents, I get it. It's cheap, and it's an easy way to go about it. But man, you just run such a high risk. And then the scotch tape just further tells me that this guy's cheap when it comes to, or doesn't really care. Just ruins the top loader. This is so annoying. So annoying. Look at that. Get all kinds of crap and goop on there. Jesus Christ, man. Anyway, Clint Capella. Gold to 10, if I'm not mistaken. Yep. So I've been trying to pick up some more gold. See, look at that, man. That just looks like crap. Anyway, amazing card. Clint Capella, gold to 10. Love it. Absolutely love it. PC. PC type stuff. For the old PC. Let's see what's in this one. I bought a lot of... Oh, here it is right here. I'm calling him just as I'm getting them. Allen Iverson. Just highly underrated player, I think. Highly underrated, and his rookie cards are at a bit of a discount, I feel. Man, these are all beautiful. Beautiful, grade-worthy cards. This is the one that I was really looking for. Oh, yeah, baby. Nice and sharp. A little chippy on the corners. I think we've done this before where you guys can actually see. Where's my lenses at? My lenses are right here. Look at that. A little chippy on the corner. A little chippy on that corner right there. But other than that, beautiful card. Beautiful card. That's PC. PC. Look at the young boy, Allen Iverson. Man, this is a really nice card. Beautifully centered. No chips on the corners. The edges look sharp. That's a very nice card. Very, very nice card. All right. And here's the hoops. No, skybox. The skybox. I think that one was the hoops. Yep. All right, good stuff. If you guys have been asking, the link is in the description. I got an affiliate link for that through Amazon. I do check the link ever so often to make sure that the one that I have in there is the cheapest one, because there's like some that are like 17 bucks, 18 bucks. I think the one that I have it is in there is like $14. All right. Now here's the other Fleer metal Iverson that I picked up. One of the things that I've been looking at, obviously, you know, Allen Iverson is in the same rookie class as Kobe Bryant. So as I'm looking for boxes to buy for the channel and break, I'm noticing, like, you know, obviously all the boxes for anything that's going to have Kobe Bryant's rookie cards in them are going to be very expensive. And because of that, the amount of Allen Iverson rookie cards that are going to be out there probably are going to be, I mean, there's nobody's going to be pulling any new Iversons. And so because of that, This one's kind of got a bad corner. Because of that, the quantity that's out there right now is kind of what's going to be out there. There's not, I don't think anybody's going to be pulling any more Iverson rookies. And so, you know, just trying to pick them up whenever I can for relatively cheap price. Send off the really nice ones to get graded. And here's another one. This one's a little bit better condition. A little chipping. A little slight chipping, but oops, nothing too crazy. Yeah, this is in good shape for the most part. Not like that last one. That last one was just absolutely trashed. And then I got this big old package right here. I'm not sure what this is. Oh, actually, you know what? I think I might know what this is. This might be the slabs, the PSA lot of Iversons that I bought. I think that's what this is. Yep. That is exactly what this is. Oh yeah, baby. Yes, oh yes, oh yes. Here we go. These are all PSA 8. Bowman Chrome. Or Bowman's Best. PSA 8. Get another one in a PSA 8. I mean, these are just... not exactly sure what got them to an 8. I mean, this is a sharp card. Nope, that's on the case. Yep, that's a little dirt on the case there. I mean, you guys tell me. I mean, am I crazy here or what? Like, pretty sharp card. No real dings or dits. I mean, that corner is a little bit off there, but I'm just not seeing anything that's telling me that, whoa, this is an absolute 8. Same thing on this one. I don't know. Here is another one. I think this one also is a Bowman and a Topps. So again, PSA 8, not really sure why. This is an 8, but we gonna see. And then this one, the reason why I bought this one was because it was obviously it was part of that lot there, but a little off-center on the back, but it's got the coating on there. And some people are a fan of leaving the coating on or taking it off. I personally like to take it off and then send them in to get graded. I don't like leaving the coatings on there, but and then that's gonna do it. Oh, and then the other bit of mail day that I got is this bad boy right here. So this is 92-93 Hoops Series 2. I'm gonna crack this open on another video. Probably do that video right here in a second. I'm in the process of updating the recording studio setup situation here. So, you know, as I'm doing that, I'm moving stuff around. So I'm going to kind of come back to this format here where I'm in front of the table. And as we update stuff and upgrade stuff, we'll get back into some more of the analytics and stuff like that. But anyway, thank you guys for watching so much. I appreciate it. Little stack of cheap slabs there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So for these 10 slabs, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So for these 8 slabs, I think I paid maybe under $100, if not close to like 150 or something like that. So I got them pretty cheap to do this experiment. Now, the experiment that I'm working on, it's not to make money. It's obviously going to lose me some money, but I need to know. Inquiring minds need to know. I must know, especially after receiving back one of my subs from SGC that kind of just really drove home the point of why I'm doing this experiment. So we'll see. Anyway, catch you guys on the next video. Like, comment, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. Follow me on Instagram, Retro Hoop Breaks. Check out Collect 3D Prints for your beautiful slab. And this one's a mag display, but it's kind of got like this thing on here. You can open them up and you can display them. I have a ton of, let's do this. I'll take you guys over here. See, I got all my stuff displayed right here. Obviously got HGA slabs, PSA display cases, SGC display cases. There's my Shaq rookie card. Shout out to my man Pete for the trade on that. And then horizontal mag cases. So this one's, down goes Akeem. This one's actually, you can display it horizontally. Come on now, there we go. Kind of hard to do this one hand, but there's that right there. And then the Kobe's and another Akeem, so. Anyway. All right, that's going to do it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it. Love y'all. Peace.